everyone. So good afternoon. I'm Cherish Brillon. So I'm the current program head of the Department of Communication, but I'm also a gender advocate on the side. So I also go to schools, to different schools. I'm invited to different schools to talk about gender. And I'm pretty sure, judging by my appearance, you know why. Okay, so I'm really going to be speaking from personal experiences and from point of view of someone whose gender has been largely one of the most defining things in my life. Okay, and then this discussion is going to be informal. I'll be switching from Filipino to English, and then siguro mamaya I'll be asking you some questions. I hope to hear your thoughts about it. This talk is actually a perfect opportunity for me to highlight one of my advocacy, which is gender. So from the longest time, I have been defined by how I look and how I appear to people. Okay, but in recent years, gender has been at the forefront of so many countries. In the Philippines, we're also starting to take note of that. I listed down some of the things that I hope that we can achieve for today, which is number one, get to know the difference between sex and gender. Because generally, may I ask, when you fill out a form, ano yung nakalagay doon? Di ba you're being asked about your name, ano pa? Age, and then? Sex or gender. Di ba? Minsan, hindi natin alam. But ngayon, generally, what's indicated in most forms are the word gender. Napakasimple lang niya, no? Pero yung mga ganun kasimpleng bagay, yun yung mga titingnan natin ngayon. I do hope to at least give you an overview of various gender-related issues, a number of which I've experienced personally. And then, in a way, since this is a campus setting, and then hopefully, in my talks, I just don't stop at defining what gender is and how it affects us. But I also suggest ways on how to actually create a safe space for everyone. So that's my advocacy, actually, in whenever I get invited to talk in universities. Can I just know your thoughts, responses on these two questions? Number one, how do you define what a man is? How would you know that someone is a girl? Or a woman? Sabi niyo, ma'am, it's really hard now. Is that true? We can argue na same thing. Ma'am, this person has a female genitalia. Generally, no, when people would define, oy, babae yan or lalaki yan, they would define it based on like gender roles or expectations of society when it comes to gender. Meaning, if you're a woman, you're supposed to like be at home, take care of the kids, etc. Or kung hindi man ganon, you're supposed to like melodrama, di ba, chick flicks, ganyan, or you hate sports. Okay, so yun yung typical na pagtingin dati ng mga tao sa usapin ng paano mo malalaman ng isang tao ay babae at siya ay lalaki. Okay, although I'm very glad of your answers, which means I think at this point in time, the advocacy on gender has really reached at least a level of support from the young people, which is always, always nice. And in my seminars, I would always tell the students, kasi ang lagi kong audience ay estudyante, ang sinasabi ko, sa totoo lang, I don't think this seminar is really for you. I think it should be more towards people who may have a very difficult time understanding what gender is. Okay, but the young people, when it comes to gender, I'm really confident. The world is in good hands. Okay, but anyway, sige. I'll try to find a few more of your opinions on some issues, like this one, as for example. This is Angela Ponce. She just won in the Miss Universe pageant in the U.S., and she is a transgender. Later, if you've heard about what the term is, that's fine. That's really good. If not, I'll talk to you about what a transgender is. But generally, a transgender is someone who was born male but identifies as a female. Okay. And in some cases, okay, they undergo, in some cases, not all transgenders has to undergo an operation. But in some cases, in order to address the gender dysphoria meaning their physical body has to align with how they identify themselves, they undergo operations. Is Miss Universe nowadays considered still a beauty pageant? It has transcended that already. And that's why, what do we look forward to in Miss Universe pageants? The Q&A. Minsan dead man na tayo sa swimsuit, minsan dead man na tayo sa long gown. It's really parang, di ba, Q&A na. So, Miss Universe has transcended in a way. Hindi enough na maganda ka lang, hindi enough na matalino. Ngayon, kailangan may malasakit ka pa sa mundo. So, it has in a way transcended that idea already. This one. This one's still fresh. Diba? Sa tingin ninyo, ano yung gusto kong bigyan ng pansin dyan sa paalala na yan? Huwag basta makipagkita sa katex. Huwag magsuot ng maigsing damit. Huwag makipag-date. Ay, kung makikipag-date, huwag uminom ng alak. Sino yung iinom ng alak sa date? Anong implied meaning dyan? O, kung magde-date daw kayo, sino dapat yung iinom ng alak?
Babae.
Ang boring ng date, di ba? Kung di ka man lang makainom ng alak, kasi you have to watch out for your safety. Why is, the question there is now, why is the burden of safety all on the woman? Why is the burden of dressing up all on the woman? Diba? Generally kasi we have an idea that when we talk about gender, we're only talking of the LGBT. No, gender also includes man and women. Kasama sila sa gender. Diba? So, yun. Oh, sino naman ang mag-aaral ng self-defense? Sino? Babae pa rin. Nakaka-pressure maging babae sa lipunan ngayon. Kailangan lagi mahaba yung damit mo, hindi ka umiinom. In short, pag ang sinasabi niya sa'yo, huwag ka na lang lumabas ng bahay. Kasi ang lipunan ay delikado sa isang babae. Can you see how oppressive that thing is? It's very oppressive. It's hard to be a woman. Don't worry, guys. Mamaya pag-uusapan natin how hard it is to be a man also. What can you say about the picture? Anong hawak ng bata? Barel. Anong hawak ng babae?
Manika.
Sa murang edad pa lang, nakikita na natin kung ano ang implikasyon ng gender sa ating lipunan. Why are toys also gendered? Why are colors gendered? Kung ikaw ay nanay, o kung mag-asawa kayo, tapos nabalitaan ninyong mga buntis ka, tapos nagpa-ultrasound ka, oy, it's a boy. Tapos, okay, tara, bili na tayo ng, ano, ng gamit ng baby. Anong bibili niyong gamit ng baby?
Blue.
Superman. Diba? Iron Man. Pag nalabalita ka mong babae, ano ipipintura mo sa kwarto niya? Pink. Paano kung boy ka, pero favorite mo yung pink? Paano kung ang mga bata wala silang gender, di ba? So when they go to the toy store, whatever toy that they want, they'll get it. And then here comes our parents saying, wag yan, pang lalaki yan eh. Ba't ka pa kuha ng barrel o ng G.I. Joe? O kung lalaki siya, pumunta siya sa Barbie, gusto niya yung Barbie. Wag yan anak, bakla ka ba? Bakit Barbie yung gusto mo? Very early age, the choices of toys already genders us. Okay? At para sa mga tao, katulad ko na mahilig sa superheroes, isa sa kinakalungkot kong bagay ay kukonte ang mga action figures ng babaeng superheroes. Okay? Like, for example, sa Avengers, pag gusto kong bumili ng collectibles, bakit ganun? Avengers naman si Black Widow, ba't wala siyang laruan? Bakit ganun? Gusto ko ng tumbler na Black Widow, ba't wala siya sa choices? Kailangan ito lang? So at a very young age, gender is already being imposed on us. Imposed because we don't get to, obviously, in the beginning, choose it. And that's why boys grew up thinking that they should like this sort of things and they should only be doing this sort of things because they are boys. And women who are supposed to like these toys. Nung bata ako, hindi talaga ako mahilig sa manika kasi natatakot ako sa kanila. I think I was traumatized by Chucky. So I think alam niyo kung gaano kapangit si Chucky. Okay, so I was traumatized by that and I don't really want to play with dolls. So I really wanted like boy toys. Although I think that's an indicator of how I grew up, but not all the time. Okay, not all the time. Now, kanina pa ako gender ng gender dito. Sabi ko to si ma'am, daldal na agad ang daldal ng gender. In fairness, intro pa lang yan, dami ko nang nasabi. Okay, but what is this gender that we're talking about? Okay. Later, i-introduce ko rin sa inyo ano yung sex at bakit mas ginagamit natin yung gender kesa sa sex. At minsan, hindi ko alam kung naiintindihan ba natin na pag hinihingi mo ay sex, ito siya. Pag hinihingi mo yung gender, ito siya. Okay? So, when we talk about gender, it's basically an interrelationship between your physical traits, your internal sense of who you are, okay, and how that internal self is also manifested outside. Okay? We're trying to learn gender today not for us to know how to label people. Yun yung lagi kong sinasabi when I have talks. Because I think generally people would say, after nung talks na iniisip ng mga tao, so, lesbian ba ako? Straight? Cis ba ako? Straight ba ako? Ganyan ba ako? That's not our point here. The point here is that we will learn about the whole spectrum of gender so that we will understand where people are coming from. It's not because we want to label them as such, but it's more of, where are you coming from? How can we make each other's lives better? Okay? For everyone. And I'm not just talking about the minority gender or women, but also even men. Can you just imagine if you're a man and you like Beyonce, you like watching chick flicks, nadja-judge ka ng lipunan, di ba? Bakit niyo ako ginajudge? Eh, mahilig ako sa Sex and the City. Ano naman? That does not make me less of a man. And look at how also society judges women who cannot bear a child. Di ba? Parang sa at, parang katuloy yung mga babae, talagang they would undergo so many things to themselves. Papahirapan nila talaga yung katawan nila para magkaanak. And when you ask them, why? And it's because society has conditioned so much of us to think that women can only be called a woman if they bore a child. Diba? So, complex. Okay, yung complexity ang ating yung complexity ng isang pagkatao ang ating pag-uusapan ngayong araw na ito. Okay. So, may tatlo pong dimension ng gender. The body, the identity, and our expression. Okay? So, the body is basically physical. So, ang body hindi lang siya physical. Okay? It's not just what's between your legs, but also how you decide to express yourself in externally. Okay, so yun yung body. Identity, sabi niya kanina, so clearly articulated, how we define ourselves. Okay, how we look at ourselves. And I think yung adolescent years is like one of the most confusing times, because this is really where you're trying to find out who you are. And I am really, really just happy that that young people today has so many of these resources available, that kahit na may mga problema tayo pa rin on bullying and everything, marami na kayong pwedeng mapuntahan. Mas madali na umintindi ang ating mga kaibigan. Nung time ko, I didn't have that much freedom. Okay, I was asking myself who I was when I was really young. I don't have anyone to talk to. I don't have an internet. Okay, I really don't know where to go. I studied in an exclusive school for girls where our teachers, when they feel that you're being very close with each other, paghihiwalayin nila kayo, tapos parang kayo wala namang mali siya kasi tropa lang naman kayo, pero bakit ganon? Okay. So sa sobrang desperado ko, pumunta ako sa pare. Kinonfess ko sa kanya, na sabi ko, I'm so confused, etc., etc., etc. Si Father, pinagdasal ako ng isang buong rosaryo. Sabi ko, ay, para naman akong pumatay ng isang tao, para mag, pinagnovina ako, tapos pinagdasal ako ng lahat ng mysteries, dasalin mo. So sabi ko, wow. So, I mean, can you just imagine? And that's why I'm really very happy that kids nowadays have, I mean, there's still a lot to be done, but you have, we're starting to have a good support system, which I didn't have when I was young. Then, of course, expression. Expression talks about, again, how we present our gender to the world, our community, our society, and it talks about gender roles. Okay, ito yung pinag-usapan natin kanina. Women are expected to be this, and men are expected to be that. And for the longest time, there's only been two, men and women. Now we have a lot, and it gets kind of confusing. Okay, but yun nga, the fact of the matter is, it's not just man and woman now. And I'm also going to be talking about that in a more biologically related sense. Okay. So, pero klara tayo ha, we have the body. Okay. Our identity, which is here. And of course, our expression. Okay. Now, let's meet the gender-bred person. Okay. Sino ang gender-bred? It's an exposition of what I just showed you a while ago. So a gender-bred person has these four elements: the identity, the attraction, the sex, and the expression. Okay? Iisa-isahin natin siya. But remember kung saan siya nakalagay. Ang identity, nasan siya? Nasa brain. Ang sex, nasan siya? What's between your legs? Okay. Ang attraction, nasan siya? Ay, gusto natin yan. Puso-puso. Ayan. Okay. And ang expression, nasaan siya? Nasa panglabas. Kaya nakikita nyo, it's the broken arrow there. Okay. So, we'll get to it one by one. So that we'll understand where are all of these things coming from. Where are all this oppression, repression towards all genders are coming from. Sabi ng isang pag-aaral, ito, sinimplify niya yung ibig sabihin, yung difference ng sex at ng gender. Yung sex daw, ito yung generally the X and Y chromosomes. Okay, what's between your legs, genitalia? Do you have the female reproductive system or the male reproductive system? Okay, kaya makikita ninyo, sex is like the DNA, the chromosomes, di ba, yung lungs, ganyan. Everything else. But look at this gender. Very different. Behavior. That's behavior. This is how you dress. This is how you relate with others. Then that one is your place in the world. And then this one is who you want to be. Okay. Dati, pag sinabi nating male and female, ito, ang akala natin, di ba, ang meron lang ay male at female. Okay. But nowadays, when you talk about sex, you're basically talking about the biological characteristics. Kung female, may vagina, may ovaries, may X chromosome, may estrogen. Kapag lalaki ka, you have a penis, you have a testes, you have X and Y chromosome, etc. O, ikaw yung pwedeng makabuntis. Yan. Pero, hindi na lang siya ngayon binary. When I say binary, dalawa. Okay? Because in recent years, marami nang lumalabas at nag-a-identify ng intersex. Okay? So, it is categorized under the idea of sex, which is biological. Okay? Ibig sabihin, ano ba yung intersex? Sila yung mga tao na yung chromosomes, yung hormones, yung sexual organs, they are not in line with our perceived male and female anatomy. Dati, ang tawag sa kanila, hermaphrodite. Okay? Yung development ng kanilang genitalia, for example, is parang contains both characteristics of both men and male and female genitalia. Okay, tapos minsan 'di ba there are people na pag tinignan mo para si ang physical makeup nila parang lalaki pero for example meron silang boobs. Okay? Kasi iba ang anatomy ng babae, iba ang anatomy ng lalaki, but at the same time iba ang intersex. And for the longest time, ang daming kaso ng intersex kasi pag nakita ng magulang na yung anak nila is born with is an intersex, ang nagde-decide doktor tsaka magulang kung ano yung gagawin sa baby. Okay? And then the baby, and then this person grows up feeling very confused about his or her body. Okay? Kasi ang nagde-decide dati ng mga ganyang bagay ay mga doktor at magulang. So can you just imagine, There were cases na pinapa-align nung magulang yung genitalia sa babae or sa lalaki. So kung bata ka pa, wala kang power to do that. Okay? And then yun sa atin, pag sinabi mong hermaphrodite, dati 'di ba ano siya? It's a being used as a derogatory term. Parang hindi ka sure kung saan ka. Pero yun nga, kasi may third category, hindi lang siya lalaki at babae. So when people would ask, so ibig sabihin ganito yan, pag tinanong sa inyo ay sa form, sex, madali lang ang choice, di ba? Kasi tatlo lang. And yung intersex is very, ano naman, it's something that's rare. Okay? So yun. Sex is an easier subject to talk about. Ang mas komplikado, yung natitirang tatlo. Ano yung tatlo? Identity, expression, attraction. Okay. Dito na tayo magkakanda, labo-labo. Kasi yung sex, madali lang yan. Yung muku ka, tingnan mo, alam mo. Okay. Pero pag pinag-usapan na natin ang identity or our sense of ourself, marami na siyang terms. Okay? Ang isang term dyan ay yung tinatawag nating cisgender. Ano yung cisgender? Nakikita ninyo yung placement ng word? Align. Align yung sex that you were born in sa iyong pag-identify sa sarili mo. So, kung ikaw ay may penis, tapos you identify as a man, that you're a cisgender. Okay? It comes from a Greek word. Okay? So, kung ikaw ay babae, you're born with a vagina, then you identify as a woman, you're a cisgender. Okay? Transgender, on the other hand, are people who are born male or female, but identify as the opposite. Yun yung transgender. Okay. At inulit ko, for you to identify as a transgender, you don't need to undergo operation. Okay. As for example, former Isa Siguera, diba, identifies as a transgender man. And dati, yung mga nakukuha kong tanong, so ma'am, transgender pa rin siya kahit wala siyang planong magpa-sex change operation. Sabi ko, yeah, kasi it's identity. It's how you identify yourself.